Hello, so I have a few bases, but I never really built any of them on video, so we'll build this one on video, at least the first part of it. Now I have a base in the meadows, another one in the meadows, which is near the swamp and the mountains and the water. Then I have another one near, I mean in the swamp directly, another one in the mountain, of course, near the merchant. Now the only thing I need to kind of finish the content of the game is a base in the plains. Now, what is the perfect plains? Well, first of all, before you leave, make a portal named Plains. Have enough supplies to make a portal. Yeah, that would be a good idea. Let's get my wood. And I actually have a few types of plains, so same as the swamp. Some swamps don't have the goblins, some swamps are kind of dangerous and have a lot of creeps, but so are the plains. Sometimes the plains are a little too easy, so if you're on the best location for a base in the plains, this is it. So usually want to build your base on top of a rock or something high. Now this has two goblin villages over here and over here, and it's actually separated by the water, so you can shoot at the goblins even from the edge of the water, maybe build a watchtower. But these villages over here don't have the crops, so if the goblin villages are smaller, they don't grow crops. You need the villages that grow crops, that have barley and flax, especially flax. Flax is the thing you need to build the best armor in the game, padded armor and some other stuff. I'll actually go over all of that a little bit later when I finish the base, but for now, let's just build a provisory base. So what do you need to resist in the plains? Well, the armor is pretty good if you have the silver one, but to be honest, you don't really want to get it. So most of the armor I have used and upgraded is for the mosquitoes. A shield, a melee weapon, whatever you want. Upgraded bow, fire arrows and frost arrows, especially frost arrows. I'm not sure if we'll have enough time to kill the goblins, but we'll certainly do a lot of work, so I'm also carrying a lot of wood and a lot of resources on me, because this will be a long expedition. I'll build my base over here, which is exactly between two big goblin villages, and by big I mean they're huge. They have two or three berserkers in them and some other stuff. So let's go over to my mountain base, which is near the base of the plains. And this will be a fun one, because the base is actually fortified and it has spikes and it's on a steep incline. So if you want to try how good the goblins are, you might as well just wait over here for them and shoot them with some arrows. Because they will climb this ledge. They will climb this ledge and the mosquitoes will also climb it, so... Wow, did you see that mosquito? It's waiting for me. It's smelling my blood, so I have to avoid the goblin base. I think we can almost see it from here. They're not so strong, this is the spear goblin. Oh, come on, that's silly. No, not going to mess around with the goblins. Also, don't mess around with the mosquitoes. See, this is what gets people killed, being distracted. And that's actually enough to kill it, so... Yeah, even with this armor, you can't take a lot of hits, so that's why I have some potions with me. That's why I came fully prepared for this. Okay, there's another mosquito, you might as well... There's my body over there. Don't worry, you'll get the timing of your attacks and you'll kill the mosquitoes as soon as you hear them. To be honest, I don't want to fight the goblins in the fog, so let's move away from this place. As you can see, this armor will make you slow, so you might want to unequip it, which sounds like madness, but the goblins will do a lot of damage regardless of if you're wearing armor or not. So if you have already scouted the area and if you know what you're doing and if you are pretty confident in your abilities and you have some healing potions, you can just go like this. It's much faster. Now, I have a few locations for a base. I mean, I could make a perfect base over here. See this boulder? It would make a perfect base because I have a lot of land near it, so I can build the farms, and it has a lot of trees near it, so it has the perfect elements, but I just want to build my base Near the two goblin bases. And you know, in case things go very, very bad, I can climb up the mountain, and because I have the wolf cape, I will not freeze. So again, it's a lot of safety issues, and of course I want more space to build stuff. And I also want to farm a lot of berries, so that will be my base location, believe it or not. You smell blood, right? The mosquitoes are very, very bad if you don't hear them or see them or if they catch you off guard. Now, this is a perfect overview. This is how I found the goblins. As you can see, it's a big village and they have the crops over there. I'm not sure if that is flax or barley, but I think it's both. Otherwise, I'll just have to go to the other goblin base, which is kind of far away. Okay, so don't worry about many things. So I think I'll build my base, okay, at this elevation. Don't worry, we can build a workbench a little later. So I want a little place for the fireplace to be. I'm not sure if I'll build a smelter or not. I actually think... Remember, you can also... Actually, let's do this right now. Kind of terraform a little bit the boulder. So you don't really have to keep everything as it is, you can level it down a little bit. Sadly, as you can see, it will destroy the entire rock, not just the level of it, so it's a little bit based on your luck. I mean, this would have been better, but I don't want to work so much. I don't want to carry back a lot of stone with me and then raise the level. Again, it's a lot of work. So let's make it a little smaller, or at least have a lot more building space. This is all about making your life easier, because if you want to make your life hard, oh, there are so many ways. Okay. I mean, we can keep this, but I want to build walls all around the place, so I don't have problems with expanding my base. Guys, we need a platform that goes down to the farm. The farm will actually be defended by a lot of wooden poles, or what are they called? Sharp stakes. No, I choose this location and not the other one because this is a little higher on the ground, and if the goblins come into a full raid, like I said, you can just go up the mountain. And you don't want your base to be downhill because the goblins can throw spears at you. Or their mages might actually target you. Okay, this is a little better. Not exactly perfect, but we'll have to do with that. So right now we just have to put down our portal and our workbench. Let's put it over here. It will be fine enough. So now let's set the tag. As you can see, it's not very hard to settle in the plains either. You just have to be careful of your location, and we'll keep the rock edge because it's impossible for the goblins to climb this, at least for now. And I don't think the berserkers can destroy it fully. So let's begin constructing it. As you can see, I want to keep it kind of leveled, so the level I'll build it will be this one. So it's in line with everything else. Designing a base is very hard work in this game. It's mainly because a lot of people want it to look better instead of being very, very functional. I think this is why people have a hard time advancing in the game. They want everything to be pretty, not functional. Okay, now we can actually build it under the bench. Anyway, if that doesn't work, you can just jump down and put it like this. So there are more ways to put down the... what? Keep calm and wait a little bit. The game is silly sometimes. Okay, destroy it. Rebuild it. Again, you don't have to choose the hard way. You can always do it the easy way. If it doesn't work, just destroy it and put it again. Also, as you can see, it's the morning. Don't try to do this during the night because enemies might spawn and you don't want that. So, this is how I start most of my bases. Oh, that will not actually build inside the rock. Well, that's a not such a big problem. We can manage. Okay, initially I thought that I have to play this a lot safer, but apparently it's pretty safe as well over here. Now, I'm only building the walls a little bit, so I have kind of like a general idea where the base will expand, because you don't want to start leveling the ground and then deciding, well, that will not work. No, no. You want to be sure when you are doing this. I guess I can go one or two more levels, so you can always build until it collapses. If it collapses, it means it needs a pillar as a support, and that's probably a good sign you should not build it anymore. Also, I have this patented building technique. I can see a mosquito. Just build it on top of it, and then you can build it like that. And of course, if that doesn't work again, you can build it over there, and then it will... I'm keeping my eye on that mosquito. He looks very suspicious to me. And this is why I brought a lot of wood, because I'm sure I'll not be able to do this in one go, and it will actually be a lot of redoing over and over. Yeah, that will not work. Okay, that's the maximum distance you can build it. And we'll keep it like this. I want to keep this place as kind of like a reminder to where to put my fireplace, because I'll put my fireplace on the rock itself, and also probably the smelters, because this is very close to the ocean, so I can bring iron from this base or even silver from this base. It's actually pretty easy to go there. I just have to remember not to land on the plains. I have to land over here in the Black Forest. And maybe I'll build a trench... a trench set and some other stuff around here. Okay, that could work as well. Also, I want to put down a few chests. Again, this is not permanent, but it will be required in the beginning. Usually with three chests you are set. So let's build a little bit of the floor again. It will be a bit of a boring experience, but I just want people to see how you can do it without cheating, without, you know, wasting a lot of time. And this would be the main chest. Let's put all of the stuff. Okay, let's put this over here as well. And we'll also try to kill a lot of goblins at the end of the video. Make sure you are fully fed and make sure your shield is up. Now, you should always check if the portal is working or not, because in case you need to escape, you will want to go back. Now, I think I have it over here, yes. It's a level 3 one. Okay, let's replace the healing potions with this one. We'll need it a lot. As you can see, I came prepared for a war, but the war is not really going well for them. Also, this is a place where I can mine a lot more stone because I'm close to the mountain as well. So if I need a lot more stone, I can just go into the mountain. But this should be enough for the beginning of the game. Now, usually all my bases in the beginning don't have much in them because it's a process. I will see what I need. I'll try to make what I need. This base will be a lot more different because I'll try to make it more on the ground than anything else. So again, it's a lot of decision making. I mean, I could use some torches over here, I'll probably build them a little later. So, I want this part of the base to be fully solid ground. Oh, wait, I can't put it. Oh, that's so silly. So, I guess I have to raise the entire ground before I can do that. Not a problem for me. This is the first time I'm building a base like this. Well, I guess I can improvise a little bit. Yeah, let's check it out. Now, I went back here to look at something and then I'll be right back to that base. If your main base has enough, I mean, if it has the cooking station, the comfort, the fermenters and all of the other stuff, then you don't need to build as much in the other bases as well. Yeah, I think it will be nighttime very soon. Okay, that's enough. Okay, this is what I wanted, more wood. Ah, don't worry, you can go through a portal and then just drop it off in the ground. I should have built this a little better. Okay, since it's getting nighttime, I want to rush the project a little bit. I'll not have time to raise the ground near the base, so I'll just have to improvise again a little more. Yes, we are feeling very, very cold, sadly. That means we need a fire, and actually the fire can be put in a lot of weird places as well. This is why I kept this like this over here. Okay, let's make it look a little better. Now, usually I would build a couple of the torches, but to be honest, sometimes you need to build it very, very fast, so let's continue building. And I'll just increase the gamma. There, that's a lot better. Don't want to leave it like that, because that will only set you back if you leave it like this in the long run. Now, you want this as the palisades, because you don't want to get attacked from the sides. And you also want to shoot all around your base, because sometimes the little enemies will just go all over your base. And believe me, this happened to me when I built it in the swamp. The enemies would just move all around. Even the swamp boss would move all around. Hey, don't do that. I think we'll build a ladder over here, so... Hey. They really need to do something about the building. Yeah, some people said use mods, but I don't want to use the mods. Now, this is the tricky part, because the hardest thing is to expand another set of levels. Perfect. Now, you could also build it on the ground, but defending a base on the ground in the plains, well, that's an entirely different thing. As you can see, even the most basic goblin will deal a lot of damage. Even one will deal a lot of damage, to be more precise. See, this is the end. Even though it looks like you could build more, it's actually not supported. So that means you need to build a little pillar over here. Now, usually you want something that snaps into place. Okay, I guess I need a cord. Okay, we'll get a cord. If it snaps into place, then it's perfect. So let's get some cord. As you can see, sometimes you just need a lot of different materials to make your base work. It's not all about the wood or the stone. And when daylight actually comes, we'll have to start killing the goblins, the little nightmare-ish goblins. So when it snaps into place, that means it's perfect. Hey, come on, stop doing that. Stop sliding all over the place. The sooner I get this done, the better it will be for me. It's still not supported, come on game, that's silly. I don't know, that looks like it could support it. Anyway, the building is not in tip-top shape like I would want it to be, but we can manage. We'll start building the ramps a little later. And this is kind of like the full creative process. So let's put the core wood over here. And another thing you should always keep in mind is that you'll want entrances from all of the sides. Okay, so this will be kind of like the outlying area of the base. And I want one more over here. That should be enough. It's always a lot easier if you do the edges first, because you want to know how it will be like in the end. Kind of like the finished product is very important. So there we go again. Okay, that's a perfect snap on. Had the pillars crushed. Okay, then let's try it a smaller one. Okay, game, you wanted it there, it's there. Yeah, that's because it's still floating. Okay, let's get a little more cord. I mean, the long night will await us. I guess people should really prepare for things like this, because this is what they don't really show you when they're streaming the game. What? Where did it snap? Okay, do you expect it to work like that? Again, just trust the game. If the game wants it to happen, it will happen. If not, well, try something else. It's like I'm in the water and I'm fighting with the water. See, it doesn't have to be pretty, it just has to be completed. Okay, that's done over there. Now, is it really so important for me to have that extra layer? Not really. Not really. We can live without that one. I mean, it will take a lot of work to actually put the final one over here. So we'll just have to do it like this. As you can see, most of it is ready. And if you want to build a smelter, it will have to be on this place as well. So for now, let's just continue building. I mean, I have a lot of supplies to build this anyway. Can I make another one over here? I will not use more materials than this, but I just want to be sure. Okay, that's actually pretty good. Now let's go back and get a lot more wood. You have to come prepared, so I think you need about 400 wood or something like that in order to build a base. And some stone if you really want to level up the ground. I mean, I want to raise the ground up so I don't have to use other platforms. Ah, why not? Let's do it like this. Sometimes you forget about the little details and you take all of the materials with you. Yeah, this would have been much better as a stream. So, yeah, let's see. Now we have all the corners, we have the base done. How dangerous do I want to live? I always make my base too big because I'm playing alone, and if you're playing alone, this base is way too big for what you need. So don't go the same path I'm going right now. Make them smaller. Trust me, you like them smaller and they'll be a lot easier to build and maintain smaller. Okay, so we covered all of the holes. And again, don't force it. If it works, leave it like that for the time being. One of the biggest mistakes I made was actually trying to be perfect. So if you want to be perfect in this game, it's way more time consuming. And if you're not playing with cheats or if you don't have any friends to play with, the time investment will not really be worth the final project. I'll stub my toes on these things a lot of times. Okay, and that's done. The base is done. Ouch, my toes. So now let's actually build the basics. I think I showed this a lot of times, but in case people want to see it again. I'm gonna use the 45 angle tiles for the roof. They're actually pretty easy to make and to assemble. You might be wondering, why is it so high? Well, I don't want to hit my head on the roof. Starting to smell like bacon. And I'll probably want to defend all of my base with that, and the tiles actually go into two sets like this. That should kind of do it for the roof. See, it works now. Now, of course, if it still says that, that's because you need to put it the other way around. This one is too exposed. Why? It should work because it's under the roof. Well, let's actually build the floor over here. Maybe that's contributing it to the problem. And as a matter of fact, the fireplace is on the floor. Okay, if the game tells you the station is still too exposed, that means you have to build the rest of the tiles. And I hope this will do it. Okay, game, we'll play it your own way. Apparently the game is a lot more... actually, let's build a few... If you try to build it like this, it will cost you 4 wood instead of 2 wood. So that's why I don't use a lot of windows when I first building the base. But after I build the initial base, I'll actually make a lot of windows for it, because I don't think mosquitoes will get in. Now, I think you will need the other row of tiles for the roof. Come on, game, I have a lot of goblins to kill. Don't take all day. Now, if that doesn't work, you can try to place it directly on the roof. And if that doesn't work, or if you just get annoyed enough, there are other ways of persuading the game to do what you want. I only needed to last a few seconds, okay. This is also why I love this set of tile of roof, because you can actually work from a lot of angles. Oh, okay. And here is not supported. Now, I don't really understand this. Why is it exposed? Did the developers do something for the game or something? Because it should work. Okay, let's get a little more wood. I don't have more wood. Okay, I can get more from the base. Yeah, they're not really matching, so the roof doesn't really match it, but for now, again, I just want it to work. You know what, forget about it. If it's not working, you just have to switch the station's location. And now it works because the game is silly. I think it has to do something with that little hole over there. Okay, so if it doesn't work, you just have to switch your approach to the game. Okay, so now let's leave and come back a little later. And also, if you want to bring a lot of the metals, you can do it as well. But try to limit yourself in the beginning, otherwise you'll get very, very bored of it. No enemies are attacking me, nothing is attacking me because the enemies don't really come after you when you're first entering a biome. I don't know why that is. The enemies start to attack you when you stay too long in a biome. Again, this is not really confirmed, but this is my experience from all of the games. Okay, so now you might be wondering what's next. Well, this is the tricky part, and I hope I don't get attacked. Let's actually make it a little safer in the beginning. Okay, as you can see, it's on the border. That's my body over there, I mean, one of my failed attempts that I'm not really proud of. Okay, I guess you can leave it like this. Again, this is all extra stuff. You might as well remove it and make the base smaller so you can aim below the rock. But like I said, this will be the farm, probably. This will be the farm area. This will be another farm area, and this will probably be nothing because it's too steep. Come on, game. Now, let's build some rudimentary defenses and then we'll start working on the important stuff. Okay, let's put this over here. As you can see, the belt is a huge help. Also, let's put this over here. We don't really need it right now. Let's put down some spikes and we'll start attacking the goblins in a minute. The creative process is not too big, but you need a lot of effort into it, and you need also to be very well stocked. This is probably the base while I'll use up almost all my core wood that I have kind of saved during the time I build the base. And also, I try to be very focused when I'm playing this game and doing something important, because if you get distracted by something, well, that could be lost progress. So let's have two of these. If I remember correctly, you need more wood than core wood, okay. Again, this is all temporary. Most of this will be changed. Yeah, so for the goblins you need probably 3 rows of spike because they are very resistant. So it's kind of like 1 row for the grey dwarfs, 2 rows for anything bigger than the normal grey dwarfs like the shamans or the brutes, and then 3 for the little goblins. Also, I'm doing this because I know they'll wander around my base for quite a while. That's not going to work. Again, I'm not trying to force the perfect placement because this is kind of placeholder. And I also left that intentionally so they don't climb over here. I'm not sure if they can climb this or not, but I'm not going to risk it very much. Well, the spikes are very sharp. I just tested them. And again, they tend to wander around so much that I actually started to build spikes all over the place in some cases. Now, if I finish building this, that will be the last of them because I want... okay. Okay, that's more than enough. Now let's put all of the building materials over here and let's start having fun. Now, if I die, it will be very easy for me to recover my body. That is also important for the... for the comfort. Now, you don't want to go inside their area without being fully rested and fully prepared. And this is the tricky part. I wanted to make it in real time so we can kind of see how much it will take. Again, if you want to build a smaller base, it will probably be 5 or 10 minutes faster than this. And this is why you need a good main base. If your main base is not good and well stacked, you'll probably waste a lot of time trying to get materials from the other places. Okay, let's look at the map a little bit, because I was actually afraid I might get attacked by goblins, but it appears if you go up high, you won't get attacked. The mountain is very close, so that's also a supply of stone. Also, you might be surprised that I'm not really using the carrot soup. Well, to be honest, the carrot soup is very good and I would use it, but I can't really farm that much. The boars eat all my carrots. Also, if you're wondering how this works, you just throw them. Now, you can use some other things as well, but to be honest, it's just a lot of wasted time. If your bow is good enough, you won't have any problems. I hope that's a goblin. Okay, 2 of them are already down. I think that's a shaman. I will not be able to kill the shaman in one hit. Yeah, and they still think it's funny. Okay, now I start to panic and miss my shots. But again, you should always attack them when you have the high ground. See, this is why in Star Wars the high ground is so important. Well, this is pretty bad. Okay, the shaman is down. If you're wondering why I'm using the frost arrows, hey, he is not down. By the way, he's buffing the other goblins, we don't want that. No, if they start moving, it's almost impossible to kill them, so let's wait here a bit longer until they calm down. Now, usually you don't want to take all of them at once, so if you can actually kill a few of them... at a distance, it will be much better. I think the bow is overpowered in the current version because not a lot of enemies can do anything about it. Oh, you didn't die. Is that goblin immortal? Oh no, he has one star, that's why he didn't die. So as you can see, the difference in the fullings, if they have a star or not, it's huge. I'm not sure how fast they respawn, but apparently it's not very fast. I'm almost expecting them to say something you would hear in a Diablo game. Okay, that's a bullseye. Sorry, it's not so interesting, but again, you don't want to fight the horde if you can help it. Also, this is why you attack during the day. You can see them so much better. Okay, he has a star as well. And to be honest, the goblins that have the stars are so dangerous that you might as well fight a boss. Okay, let's put my armor on, my pants. And then we'll actually loot the village, because that's the point of the video, looting and surviving over here. As you can see, silver armor can be a little bit of an overkill. But the frost arrows are definitely needed and helpful. Goodbye. Also, I wasted about 60 arrows already, so I might need to go back to my base and get some more arrows. Let's get a little more aggressive. You can see my base very clear from here, which is why one of the reasons I put it on the cliff like that. Oh wow, they actually had a lot of stars. These goblins would be a real trouble if I had to fight them fair. Also, it's a little too bright on the video, but I guess I forgot to turn down the gamma. Oh, you're still alive. Okay, let's take a small break, let's return to our base, eat, and then I'll actually go melee on them. Not really melee, as much as we can. Remember, your weapon slows you down if you are carrying it when you are... This is what kills me most of the times, the sneaky mosquitoes. Okay, that was too early, but again, I caught him with the backhand. Okay, let's go back, recuperate, regenerate a little bit. And remember, the poison is actually very good against them, so if you want to kill the goblins, just throw a lot of poison bombs on them and then... I hate to say this, but run almost naked. If a mosquito doesn't attack, you'll be perfectly safe. As you can see, this doesn't do a lot of damage. The poison damage is not actually inscribed over here, so just have to throw it and see for ourselves. The bow needs to be upgraded because look, I wasted about 80 durability off it. Hooray for being prepared. Now, this time we'll actually play it a little harder because again, a lot of people are saying the goblins are the hardest area, the plains are the hardest area, the goblins are the hardest enemy. In a way, that's true. But most of the times it will strictly depend on how you want to approach the situation. As you see, the damage I took during all of the time I spent in the plains is equal to about, what, 60 damage? And the locks are over there. Usually if you see a goblin village, the locks are quite near it. And look at how many goblins I killed. Okay, let's just go full melee on them. And by going full melee, hey Odin, did you come to help me? Wow, they have another shaman. And they also have a little goblin in that watchtower. But I guess this is a good opportunity to show you the mechanics. I can't really see him. And remember, even though the base might seem almost empty, it's not. We still have a goblin in that tower. Okay, the risks are not usually worth it. As you can see, you still need a lot of stamina to do it. But again, it's so much fun. I love killing them so brutally because I suffered a lot. When I first tried to defend myself against them. So if you poison them and then slow them, there'll be a sure, there'll be a sure target for you. So this is a lethal combination. Poison bombs, frozen arrows, or freeze arrows. So, this one might be the last one. Let me finish you off symbolically with a swing of the hammer. Now let's see what they have here. Is it flax or barley? Oh, it's flax. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. You know, I could have left you alone if you kept your mouth. This is quite heavy, but we'll just take it anyway. Why are you guys still laughing? I kicked your I destroyed you. I mean, I don't want to destroy the little bases, they're so cute. Okay, also have barley over here, which is perfect. We can get started on our crops this way. So this is the main reason you come for to their bases, the barley and the flax. The barley is not so important, but it will be kind of like the end game food, even though it's a little harder to use. Also remember that the little houses act as watchtowers. I think we can put some wood on their fire pits as well. I need more feathers. Okay, we have a goblin raiding party over there. I don't know what causes them to spawn beyond our base like that. But we'll actually leave them alone, because that's not our main purpose over here. If you overextend, you'll die. I find it so funny that they have the little tanning rocks. Usually, near the tanning rock, they also have a chest. You can also press or hold E to do it faster. Depends on how you prefer it. Yeah, it came a little heavy, but again, we have, what, 42 barley and 44 flax. And 29 star metal. I guess I'll keep the other stuff as well, because we might build the arrows. And now you can actually use their base against them, because if you kill them, you can actually go up their towers like this and start killing the rest of them. I only think the archers and the mages might be able to attack you, but other than that, you'll be perfectly safe. I mean, you can even rest on their houses, and you can also climb like this. So that's a hunting party. There's a one goblin with a flame, with a torch. Let's see what I dropped over here. As you can see, this will not work. Don't try that. Don't try to come here naked. Actually, leave the locks alone. I'll also leave the seagulls alone, because that was... I don't know. That was a huge victory for me. And again, we just cleared the goblin base with minimal effort. And we didn't get hit that much. So we can. I think you can basically skip silver armor if you really want it. Ouch. Oh, I forgot I have spikes in the grass. And from now on, it's just about 2 hours of work building my farm over here. I'll extend the spike lines to actually cover the entire hillside. And I'll actually build more workshops so I can build a bigger farm. So at this point, it's just a lot of, you know, farming and wandering around. Where did I get the bones from? I don't remember. Anyway. That's kind of like the first stages of setting up a base in the plains. See you next time. Bye.